Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Astrology 5. Today we are going to discuss about our third lesson in Gemini Jyotish, that is all the Raj Yogas which are mentioned in Gemini Jyotish. What sort of Raj Yogas are given in this branch of astrology, that we are going to see today. So let's start the video then. So today we are going to discuss about all the Raj Yogas which are mentioned in Gemini Jyotish. So far we have known that we have discussed all about Parashar Jyotish, and we have seen that what sort of yogas happen in Parashar. Means that we know that in Parashar there are lakhs of yogas, means you cannot remember them. There are so many innumerable yogas and no one can remember them. We just focus on the most important yogas like Raj Yoga, Dhan Yoga, Kendra Trikona Raj Yoga and Nich Bhang Raj Yoga, Gaj Kesari Yoga. These are some important Raj Yogas which are mentioned in Parashar Jyotish, and we have seen this. But in Gemini Jyotish there are far less number of Raj Yogas in Gemini Jyotish, and they are finite in number. You can easily remember them and you can easily apply them in any horoscope of any person. Okay, so that we are going to discuss today. In Gemini Jyotish, the Raj Yogas are formed on the basis of the conjunction or aspects of Gemini Karaks. There are seven Karaks, and if you don't know what Gemini Karaks are, how the aspects in Gemini Jyotish work, you can go in the playlist of my channel and you can view these two videos I have made, lesson 1 and lesson 2 in Gemini Jyotish. You can easily see that and learn that how Karaks are seen, what are Karaks, and how aspects work in Gemini Jyotish. So this is a third lesson in Gemini astrology which we are going to see today, and we are going to learn all sort of Raj Yogas and Dhan Yoga which is made in Gemini Jyotish according to Gemini principle, not according to Parashar. Okay, so let's start with this. See, there are seven Karaks we all know in Gemini Jyotish. There are Atma Karak, Amatya Karak, Matri Karak, Bhratri Karak, Putra Karak, Dar Karak, okay, and Gnati Karak. These are seven Karaks. All these seven Karaks do not form Raj Yoga. There are only four Karaks which are responsible for all the Raj Yogas mentioned in Gemini. They are Amatya Karak, Atma Karak, Dar Karak and Putra Karak. These are four Karaks which form Raj Yoga. Rest of the three are not included in any sort of Raj Yoga. And one other planet apart from these four is the Lord of the fifth house in your main birth chart. That is important. So these five planets together, they form Raj Yogas and Dhan Yoga in Gemini Jyotish. And what sort of Raj Yogas and Dhan Yogas are formed, that we are going to now discuss. First of all, I am going to tell you about all the Raj Yogas which are formed by Atma Karak. Atma Karak is a planet with the highest degrees and it is one of the most important planets. Okay, so first of all, the most important Raj Yoga and most strong Raj Yoga mentioned in Gemini is when Atma Karak and your Amatya Karak, that is planet with the second highest degree, they both are in conjunction or they are aspecting each other. When you are seeing their aspects, you have to apply Gemini aspects. Parashar aspects are invalid here. You don't have to use Parashar aspects at all. This is a totally different branch of astrology, Gemini astrology. If you don't know how aspects work, I have made a video, you can view that. Okay, so first of all, Raj Yoga is formed. The most important Raj Yoga is Atma Karak plus Amatya Karak together, either in conjunction or they are aspecting each other according to Gemini aspects. Second is when Atma Karak is sitting with Putra Karak, and either in conjunction or aspecting each other. Third is when Atma Karak is sitting with your fifth lord of the main birth chart, either in conjunction or they are aspecting each other. Fourth is when Atma Karak is sitting with Dar Karak in conjunction or they are aspecting each other. So these are four Raj Yogas which are formed by Atma Karak. And the most important, I have mentioned all of them in serial order according to their strength. This means that the first yoga is having maximum strength, then the second one, then the third one, and then the fourth one. Now, the next yogas are formed by Amatya Karak. Amatya Karak means planet with the second highest degree in your horoscope. There are three Raj Yogas formed by Amatya Karak. First is when Amatya Karak is sitting with Putra Karak, either in conjunction or in aspect with each other. Then when Amatya Karak is sitting with Dar Karak, either in conjunction or in aspect with each other. Then when Amatya Karak is sitting with your fifth lord of the main birth chart, either in conjunction or they are aspecting each other. Third, Raj Yogas are formed by Putra Karak. Okay, so when Putra Karak is sitting with your Dar Karak in your main birth chart, either in conjunction or in aspect with each other, it is also one sort of Raj Yoga. And when Putra Karak is sitting with your fifth lord, either in conjunction or in aspect, it is also one sort of Raj Yoga. Last is when your Dar Karak is sitting with your fifth lord, that is also a Raj Yoga when it is sitting with fifth lord, either in conjunction or in aspect with each other. So these are total 10 Raj Yogas which are mentioned in Gemini Jyotish. So you can see that there are very less Raj Yogas, and apart from these 10, only two more special Raj Yogas are there that I am going to tell you. So total number of yogas in main yogas in Gemini Jyotish are 12, that you have to remember. And I have also mentioned the serial strength serially. So most important Raj Yoga is Atma Karak and Amatya Karak. Most powerful, most strong, most beneficial is Atma Karak plus Amatya Karak. Okay, so these are 10 Raj Yogas. Now the two special cases that are there mentioned in Gemini Jyotish are when your moon in the main birth chart is aspected by minimum number of four planets. If moon is aspected by four or more planets in your main birth chart, then it is a very important Gemini Raj Yoga. Actually, it is a very powerful Gemini Raj Yoga. If the condition is moon should receive good aspects. Means that if negative planets, malefic planets, by malefic I mean that if natural malefic like Saturn or Mars or Rahu or Ketu are aspecting, but if they are very strong in your main birth chart and they are good, it doesn't mean that this yoga is nullified. It will only be nullified when malefic planets are aspecting moon and they are already in very weak position in your main birth chart. Means your Saturn is debilitated, your Rahu and Ketu are aspecting the moon from 6th, 8th or 12th house, your Mars is debilitated and aspecting the moon. So if these four planets are already in a poor condition in your main birth chart and they are aspecting the moon, then this Raj Yoga is not formed. It is not formed at all. Okay, even if moon is receiving the aspect of four planets, it is not formed because the aspect is of very poor and malefic nature. That is why. So this is how a special Raj Yoga of moon is formed in Gemini Raj Yoga, in Gemini Jyotish. And here you have to see the aspect through Gemini aspect and through Parashar aspect also. You can see, means you can apply both the aspects, means the aspects which are mentioned in Gemini and the aspects which are mentioned in Parashar, you can utilize both of them and see. So in total number, if four or more planets are aspecting and the aspects must be good and benefic in nature, if they are aspecting the moon, it is one Raj Yoga. Then the last Raj Yoga, I will not say it a Raj Yoga, it is a Dhan Yoga mainly. And it also gives sometimes the results of a Raj Yoga, but mainly it is a Dhan Yoga that is formed when your moon and your Venus are both in conjunction in your main birth chart, or they are aspecting each other. through Gemini aspect, if they are aspecting each other or they are in conjunction, then this Raja Yoga is formed. And please mention what I want to mention here is that when you are analyzing this yoga, you have to see the position of Moon and Venus with respect to each other. Means if Moon and Venus are sitting with respect to each other in 6th, 8th or 12th house, then this Raja Yoga or Dhan Yoga will not give very fruitful results because it is already happening in Dusthan houses. But if it is if Moon and Venus are sitting, for example, in Kendra from each other or Trikona from each other, 1509 or 14710 from each other, then this Raja Yoga happens, Dhan Yoga happens and gives very beneficial and fruitful results in person's life. So these are 12 Raja Yogas which are mentioned in Gemini Jyotish. And apart from these 12, you don't have to remember any other Raja Yoga. And you will be able to analyze everything. Everything means everything of a person's life with the help of these yogas in the horoscope. Okay. Now, what I want to mention more is that when you are analyzing the conjunction, you also have to look at the degrees. If Atma Karak or Amartya Karak, say, for example, are sitting in conjunction in anyone's horoscope. For example, let's take Moon is your Atma Karak and Venus is Mercury is your Atma Amartya Karak. Then and both are sitting together. Then you have to analyze the degrees of both the planets, Moon and Venus, Moon and Mercury. If their degrees are very much apart, the gap is very large, then this yoga is just happening for the namesake. It is not going to give you any results in its time period. So you have to see that degrees, if they are close together, approximately 5 to 7 degrees, if the gap is of 5 to 7 degrees, it is considered a strong Raja Yoga. If more than that, then the strength will be degraded further. Okay. So when you are seeing the Raja Yoga, you have to check the conjunctions. When you are analyzing conjunctions, you have to see the degrees. Then similarly, all the Raja Yogas which I have told you till now, you have to apply it and check it in your D9, that is Navamsha chart. Also Navamsha chart must be analyzed properly, and you have to just repeat all the procedures and see what sort of Raja Yogas are formed in Navamsha chart. If your Navamsha chart is having more Raja Yogas than your main birth chart, it signifies that you will get more success in your after your middle age. And even if you are going to get any sort of problems in your life, that are going to be removed and their intensity will be much less. So if Raja Yogas are more in Navamsha, if the case is reverse, means if your Lagna chart is having more Raja Yogas and Navamsha is having less Raja Yogas, it means that after middle age you are going to face some serious problems. Not serious, I'm just telling about, you are going to face some struggles, and your what you want to have in life, that is going to have serious, you have to get it by struggling. You will not get easily anything which you want. You are not going to get it easily. So that it signifies. And if any problem is going to arrive in your life, that is not going to go easily in your out of your life. Okay, that it shows. So this you have to see. And what you also have to analyze is what are the strength of your karaks. All the karaks which are forming the Raja Yogas and which are not forming the Raja Yogas, that must be analyzed. Their strength must be seen. If they are afflicted, if they are debilitated and in a poor strength, both in Lagna chart and Navamsha chart, it means that the Raja Yoga, if it is forming a Raja Yoga, this planet is not going to give good results. Because that planet is not having strength, it is already very weak in your main birth chart as well as your D9 chart. So this way you have to analyze. So I think this is what I have to tell you. These are all Raja Yogas which are mentioned in Gemini. And the good thing about Gemini is that you have to remember less, and your accuracy develops, what you develop is very much higher than Parashar. सी इन पराशर यू नीड अ वेरी स्ट्रांग बेसिक फाउंडेशन, वेरी वेरी स्ट्रांग, एंड यू हैव टू बी वेरी मच प्रैक्टिस्ड इन पराशर सिस्टम बिफोर प्रिडिक्टिंग. बट इन जैमिनी यू डोंट रिक्वायर एनी ऑफ दोज थिंग्स. दैट इज वाई इट गिव्स यू मच मोर एक्यूरेट रिजल्ट्स एंड थिंग्स आर फार लेस एज कंपेयर टू पराशर. सो दैट इज वाई as you are seeing here in Parashar there are lakhs of yogas and here only 12 yogas that you have to see. So this is my view on the Raj Yogas which are formed in Germany, how you have to analyze them. So if you are new to my channel, subscribe below for more. Check on my Twitter and Facebook page. Otherwise we will meet in the next lesson of Jaimini Jyotish. We will discuss about some more important topic. I will make a video on either Arudha Lagna or Chardasha. I will decide that. So that we are going to discuss in the next lesson. So if till then, goodbye and thank you.